Reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 4th canto, chapter 5, text number 1. Maitreya uvacha bhavo bhavanya nidhanam prajapate asatkritaya avagamya naradat swapashyada sainyam chatad advararam bubhe vidravitam krodam aparam adhadade. Translation purport by Srila Prabhupada. Ki jai. Maitreya said, when Lord Shiva heard from Narada that Sati's wife was now dead because of Prajapati Daksha's insult to her, and that his soldiers had been driven away by the Ribhu demigods, he became greatly angry. Purport. Lord Shiva understood that Sati, being the youngest daughter of Daksha, could present the case of Lord Shiva's purity of purpose and would thus be able to mitigate the misunderstanding between Daksha and himself. But such a compromise was not attained, and Sati was deliberately insulted by her father by not being received properly when she visited his house without being invited. Sati herself could have killed her father, Daksha, because she is a personified material energy and has immense power to kill and create within this material universe. The Brahma Samhita, her strength is described. She is capable of creating and dissolving many universes. But although she is so powerful, she acts under the direction of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna as a shadow. It would not have been difficult for Sati to punish her father, but she thought that since she was his daughter, it was not proper for her to kill him. Thus she decided to give up her own body, which she had obtained from his, and Daksha did not even check this. When Sati passed away, giving up her body, the news was conveyed by Narada to Lord Shiva. Narada always carries the news of such events because he knows their import. When Lord Shiva heard that his chaste wife, Sati, was dead, he naturally became exceedingly angry. He also understood that Bhrigumuni had created the Ribhu Deva demigods by uttering the mantras and of Yajurveda, mantras of the Yajurveda, and that these demigods had driven away all of his soldiers who were present in the arena of the sacrifice. Therefore, he wanted to reply to this insult. Thus, he decided to kill Daksha because he was the cause of the death of Sati. Just how so Narada communicated to Lord Shiva the situation where his wife had committed, taken away her life on her own Siddhi. Lord Shiva became very angry, and he was also angry that all the soldiers who were protecting her was driven away by the demigod Ribhu demigods. And then Lord Shiva became extremely angry, pressed his lips with his teeth, and immediately snatched the strand of hair from his head, and it was blazing like electricity or fire. He stood up at once, laughing like a madman, threw the hair on the ground. From that, Virabhadra, a fearful black demon, very tall, as high as the sky, bright as three suns, was created. His teeth was fearful, and hairs on the end burning like fire. He had thousands of arms. And then this gigantic demon asked Lord Shiva, what can I do for you? So Lord Shiva said, you should kill Daksha and his soldiers. And accordingly, he left for the sacrificial arena with all the followers of Lord Shiva who were driven away. And then he created a dust storm, and everybody was wondering, what is this? Something is going on. This is all due to the inauspiciousness of, created by Daksha, of not preventing his own daughter from committing suicide. This is the way of ahankara, this is the way of false ego, this is the way of pride. Pride people, proud people, when they make a mistake, they don't apologize. They again and again and again justify. This is a character that you can see, the cause of all destruction of Daksha. He was so adamant that all opportunity, even when Daksha came back to him with good intention to clear the misunderstanding that he had about Lord Shiva, she wanted to convey the good intent or the purpose in Shiva's mind. But she never got an opportunity. Daksha was so proud that he received all the other sisters of Sati, but he did not even welcome and offer a reception to Sati. That itself put her off. And then she started speaking in the assembly against her father. And finally she sat, and by yogic siddhi, she immolated herself. And even when she was about to do that, again look at Daksha's mind. He did not prevent Sati from taking her life. Did not prevent. Mind is like that. One becomes blinded. This is often seen in many instances. They say pride grows before a fall. When we are very, very attached to some argument, without seeing what the others are, or don't want to hear what others are saying. They don't want to hear what others are saying. And they will do everything to press their or justify that I am right, I am right, I am right, I am right. Because so much ego, how can I say I was wrong? So this kind of ego, false ego, is the cause of all destruction that is going to happen to Daksha and his population. You can see what kind of devastation this scenario that we are describing here. The universal yajna, with all great personalities of the universe, all rishis, demigods, all assembled, is not an ordinary event. Even in our material world, if you have Olympics, you'll say, oh, it's a big event. What is this? This is a huge event. And in that event, this competition between Brahma Tejas and Shiva Tejas is destroying power. As you go on, you will see more scenic descriptions of how this ends in killing of Daksha. So in the same way, you see, these are all not things that don't happen now. The Srila Prabhupada, great messenger, of the Supreme Lord, has told this world, has warned this world of dire consequences if they did not follow the principles of religion. But who cares? Only devotees care. Entire world, so-called leaders, they're all like dakshas. Because they're too proud about their civilization. They are thinking that they know, assuming even good leaders, they think that they know what is good for the world. And like blind leaders, today's economic development for producing more and more goods for sense gratification is unprecedented in the history. And 200 years back, almost entire production in this world was agriculture and cow milk products. This was this earth. So this agrarian civilization has transformed into an industrial civilization. And everybody started working in industries. Industries to produce goods. Goods which human being was living without. So entire activity on this earth today is an unwanted activity. Ugra karma. It is not needed for human beings. When these things are told in the normal times, no, everybody will laugh at it. What is all this? Everybody will laugh at it. But today, if you tell people, they'll at least think. It is time for us to preach. It is time for us to preach. Look what the Shastra says. Look what Prabhupada says. It's time for leaders to become humble, at least good leaders. There are suras and asuras. There are asuras, they won't listen at all. There are good leaders. But they are also ignorant. Just like Daksha was not a demon, it's a good human being. So much of pride in the modern pride by the leaders of the present society in science and technology, they are thinking that they can make people happy. Nobody would have believed that the whole world will be on its knees. Big leaders, big, how they so confident. About economic development. Just in few days everything is crashed. Few months everything is crashed. There's nothing. What we have seen is nothing. And all due to the wrath of material nature. Everything has, like Prabhupada says, laws of karma. Just like if you murder somebody, take some time. You catch the thief, then put him on trial, take evidence, put him on trial, whatever that process is there. Then at the end he'll be hanged. Just like the Nirbhaya killers. Everybody knows that they did nonsense. Everybody knows. But how long it took? How many years? 7 years it took. It was black and white to everybody. There is a process. Similarly, a man breaks the laws of nature. There's a time lapse. Every action has a reaction. And it will come. And it is coming. And this was predicted by Srila Prabhupada. It was predicted by Srila Prabhupada. Just see, there's no... Only dharma can guide humanity. Only a king or a person who knows the laws of dharma can guide the human society. How it should develop, how we should move forward. How vulnerable every living entity on this earth is under the direction of ignorant leaders who do not know the purpose of humanity, the purpose of human life, where they are to be guided. Just because you forget what the purpose is, doesn't mean purpose doesn't exist. You short circuit it, then everything goes. How fast the world was running, running fast. Sense gratification. 150 years, 200 years, industrial revolution, production. Everybody was going to the factories. Now they're saturated with products. Then what to do? Software. People were running to factories for production. Now the product produced enough. Who are the biggest software fellows? Distributing information and no product at all. Information about products and selling. Amazon, all these. Who are they? They're just selling the products. Most of the people are working in selling the products to others. One set of people are selling, then to others. All ridiculous activity. Production was from the earth, according to Vedic system. For a sustainable human development, for sustainable humanity, production means producing food from the earth, not producing artificial consumer goods. This whole consumerism is Ugra Karma. We have created so many unwanted needs. Why? Because there is no focus. What else to do with life? They do not know. Today somebody is born, the only thing he can understand looking around the world is, I should enjoy, I should succeed in enjoying. Isn't it? You cannot blame it. That's the only thing he can learn. If you say anything else, you want to join ISKCON, they'll laugh at you. Whereas everybody is supposed to have the same attitude as devotees after reading Prabhupada wants to pursue spiritual life. That was a common attitude, common denominator for every human being on earth. Why we are not after all those consumer goods? Because we are after internal spiritual journey. They are after more and more attachment. We are after more and more detachment. Because detachment, tapasya, is all the purpose or the virtues of human being. As a human being, we should take tapasya and austerities, restricting sense gratification, to realize our spiritual nature beyond this material nature, that we are beyond this material body. So simply feeding the body, polishing the body is not going to make us happy. We have to feed our soul with transcendental knowledge, hearing Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, holy name, worshipping the Supreme Lord, hearing His pastimes. That is the purpose of human life, which was very much there in this country. Even 300, 400 years back it was there. Traces of it you could see even 100 years back. I remember in my childhood days, most common cultural festival was Harikatha. Harikatha. Practically every corner of Bangalore city, you will see Harikatha goes on. That whole art itself is gone. Nicely they will sing one katha, then they will explain. So people used to go in the evening and go and sit. They go and sit and they hear. All the local people all go and sit and hear Harikatha. And those who are giving the Harikatha, they were very much respected. Just see, in such a short time, in my own lifetime, I have seen they have disappeared. And that disappeared, but that is something which was very going on for hundreds and hundreds of years. Every household used to, their thing was to hear Harikatha. Mahabharata, Ramayana, and in so many different art forms are there. Even today those forms are there, but it doesn't. You take Yakshagana, you take consider Kathakali, or in all based on Harikatha, Harikatha, Harikatha. All vanished. How blind India is. By blindly imitating the Western culture, we have destroyed even our own traditions, our own wealth. So much so that you talk to a leader today about it, it doesn't strike them. What is this? When we tell devotees what is the importance of Harikatha, they can understand. So we should understand all these perspectives, because we are product of modern world. We have to change our paradigm. We have to change our outlook towards the world. And Prabhupada has helped us, giving us so many different perspectives, where very clearly, don't have faith in this civilization, Prabhupada has clearly told. Don't have faith in this civilization. This civilization will crash. Grow your own food, Prabhupada said. Better late than never. Let us grow our food now at least. It's a stark reality.
Hare Krishna. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss any updates.